As the program runs, it will be building up internal data stores for keeping track of all the variables that are available to different function objects. And I'm going to picture that stuff over here on the right. This will be a diagram or a picture of our in-memory system. Since each new run of a function is supposed to operate in complete isolation from all the previous runs, a new execution context should be created every time you run a function. Thus, for each lexical scope, there may be many in-memory scopes created during execution, or there may be none. It all depends on how many times you run a given function in your code. To examine execution contexts, we'll need to actually run this program, so let's simulate that here. The yellow arrow will point to the position in the code where our simulated interpreter has reached, sort of like a debugger. Before this first line of code even runs, the interpreter will start out by setting up an execution environment for you. The first step will be to create an in-memory global scope context to hold all of the global variables. So let's visualize that execution context data store off to the right here. We'll use a similar color as the lexical scope region that it relates to. Here, our interpreter is building up a storage system for the global scope. The yellow border is around the interpreter's current execution context. That is to say, whichever one the interpreter starts its variable lookups in. So far, the global context is the only one that exists, so of course, it's the current scope. As the first line of code runs, the interpreter builds up a new key-value mapping inside of the execution context in order to keep track of the value that is bound to the name hero. The ahero function randomly generated the value gal, which will be stored in the hero variable. Like the line above it, this line implies a simple assignment operation. Now, the value being assigned is a function that spans several lines, but the interpreter is going to ignore all the red and the blue code for now. They will only get run when the function is actually called. So that line of code has the effect of adding a new key-value pair to our global scope context.